Newcastle Airport started, it was referred to as the tin shed. Everyone sort of lovingly referred to it because it literally was a tin shed and you walked out on the aprons. In 1948 was the first commercial flight. It was actually part of going from Sydney to Brisbane. It used to stop in Newcastle. And that route's gone on to become the 11th biggest route in the world. So since those early days, there's been significant changes and it's now a multi-million dollar terminal and as good as you'll get anywhere in the world. We've got a number of milestones this year. We've got the 70th anniversary when Newcastle Airport started operating, the first commercial flight. We've got the 17 millionth passenger since Port Stephens and Newcastle City Council took on operating the airport. And we've also got record passenger numbers. Travel's great because there's lots of happy faces and the tears on goodbye and the tears when people come together. And it also, when I walk around Newcastle, over Christmas I was hearing about 5 or 10 different languages being spoken. And that's lots of people coming in to enjoy our region, and that's also part of that connectivity story that we provide as well. Being regional is part of our DNA. So our vision is to be the airport the region deserves. So that means understanding what our passengers want, but also broader than that, what can we do to stimulate the regional economy? For example, it's trying to get some regional tourism efforts together to drive regional tourism and visitor economy, which is a great diversification for the Hunter's economy. And we are also trying to work with defence and do servicing of the F-35s and facilitate that. Create economic activity, be a real driver in the region. I mean, I think the secret to business is having a well thought through strategy, but then it's just about hard work and executing. And having discipline to execute and stick with your strategy and have grit and determination to come through ups and downs and believe in what you're doing. Another secret in terms of being in the region is working with other regional businesses. What we've found is that businesses, the Hunter, stick together, and so we look for a range of regional businesses that can work together because everyone's got the best interests of the Hunter at heart. But at times people, there's a bit of infighting as well. You've kind of got that. It's almost like a family. Lots of people know each other and they've all got history, and it's a matter of harnessing that to the benefit because it's got a lot of power and energy in it, and it's making that work. In the next 20 years, we want to more than double our passenger numbers. We've got a master plan which talks about a vision for 60 years actually. So big bits of infrastructure look out a long time because you don't want to build a terminal in the wrong spot. So you've got to think out. But we've got a very solid blueprint for the next 20 years. But suffice to say, it's giving the people of the Hunter what they want and being the airport the region deserves. So it's giving those additional routes. It's being smarter about how we provide services to people. And it's bringing airlines and passengers together to provide the travel services people need. The Hunter over the next few years, I think it has all the ingredients to go so well. We've got great investment, we're really turning a corner. I think it's a kind of a call for the business leaders and the civic leaders to make it come together and achieve that desired outcome. And I don't want to look back in 5 years and think what we could have been. I want to look back in 5 years and think, amazing, we've overachieved in terms of our dream and the potential that we had.